the word whore is used to stigmatize any woman that doesn't fit the criteria of a good girl. She could be overweight, she could have dropped out of the church, she could have gotten a divorce in the 50s. She could talk back or could talk bad and dress wrong, hang out with the wrong people, you know, things like that. So really the word whore is still used to keep other women in line, all women. But the punishment of the prostitute is the example set by the system, that if you don't act right, bow down to men, I suppose, that you'll get what's coming to you. And a lot of hookers are murdered in this country. I think it's because of, as President Bush says, the archaic attitudes toward women in this country. But I think it's more than that, because it's a criminalized system here where the victimization is institutionalized and the prostitute becomes a legitimate victim for rape, murder, robbery, any kind of abuse, verbal abuse and physical abuse.
The whore stigma is always used to justify violence against women, against any women, and the laws that forbid prostitutes to travel, to raise their own children, to have homes, to have any associates, lovers, or even to live with their families without their families being called pimps, are laws which affect all women and which restrict us, control us, justify violence against us. There's no question that in this movement, the most important start is contact, is talking, is realizing that those divisions between us have been imposed and that they're artificial and that our lives and our concerns have a great deal in common. And even our fear of stigma and the abuse that we suffer has a great deal in common. But we can only know that by talking together, by building personal relationships together, and by building a political analysis based on all of our experiences.